Yes, good morning everyone. Good morning Ramesh, Gautam, Hari, Sushila and Upasana. I hope everybody is able to hear me. They are able to watch my screen. Fine. So this is Mohan from RTL Online Training. So this training demo is regarding MuleSoft. MuleSoft training. MuleSoft is one of the integration tool, cloud integration tool, which is developed by the MuleSoft company. Okay, so now we are going to have the demo here. During the session, if you have any doubts, please enter in the chat window. You have the chat window. And still, if we are not clear, I will be, if you raise the hand, you have an option called raise hand. Please raise the hand so that I will unmute you and you can talk with me. Yes, Gautam. Yes, tell me, Gautam. Okay, fine. So let me explain about RTL Online Training is one of the leading online trainers. So RTL is offering almost all the latest technologies in online. You can go through this website and we provide the training, and every session will be recorded and this session will be shared across your Gmail ID. And once the session is completed, we'll be creating a WhatsApp group for communication during your practice at home. In case if there are any doubts, the trainer also will be on the group. So you'll be getting an immediate response from the trainer. And we will be providing you the software and installation process. Everything will support through online. If somebody would like to go for the placements through our consultancy, please contact the coordinator. These are the numbers, contact numbers regarding the placements. We will provide you the training, resume preparation, interview preparation, and also we do the placements in MuleSoft. Not only in MuleSoft, in other technologies also. So regarding the placements, contact these numbers. Okay, fine. So please drop your phone numbers and email IDs so that what we can do is we can share this demo session across your email ID. The demo session will be shared across your email ID. And we will be having the batches starts from Monday. We'll be having batches in the morning and in the evening, US timings, and as well as in the morning 6 to 7, and also in the evening 8:30 to 9:30, that's US timings we are providing for US applicants. Okay, fine. So let me introduce myself. As I told, this is Mohan, having the 9 years of experience in the integrations. Worked with different integrations and middleware technologies. I worked with Oracle SOA, Service Oriented Architecture. And also I worked with TIBCO. And now this is on MuleSoft. I'm working with MuleSoft last 3 years with different versions as a developer and also integration specialist. Okay, so this particular demo is going to give the clarity about what is MuleSoft and what things will do it by using the MuleSoft and why this is so popular in the recent last 3-4 months. and how it's going to be useful in our IT infrastructure right now. That's what we are going to discuss. And also we'll be discussing about the syllabus part of our MuleSoft, what we are going to discuss in 30 hours, the training. The training will take 30 hours, maybe 3 to 4 hours more or less. 30 working hours is required. And we'll be talking about, we'll be developing very simple MuleSoft flow. We are going to develop the MuleSoft flow so that you will get an idea on this. So somebody can say that what are the prerequisites to attend the MuleSoft particular training? So the prerequisites are basic knowledge about the programming part. Maybe if it is from Java technology, it's well and good. Or if you do not have an idea, no problem. We'll provide you the couple of sessions on that. What is HTTP? What is REST API? What is SOAP API? And how about core Java OOPs concepts, variables? What about the control statements and loops? This all we'll be discussing. Legacy systems, APIs, this all we'll be discussing for a couple of days. We'll conduct the sessions. Who are freshers will support to get into this. Fine. So let me enter into this. As I told, you have any doubts, please raise the hand. You have an option, or please enter in the chat window. So the first thing is, what is mean by Mule? So what is mean by Mule? So Mule is basically, it's a Java-based product. Mule or MuleSoft. MuleSoft is a company name, actually, name of the company. So Mule is a Java-based product which provides an enterprise service bus. So what Mule will provide, what exactly it will provide is, it will provide the ESB solutions. By using the Mule, we can get ESB solutions. ESB stands for Enterprise Service Bus. ESB stands for Enterprise Service Bus. So by using the Mule software, we can provide ESB solutions to our clients. ESB solutions to our clients. Enterprise Service Bus solutions to our client. Okay. So it's a Java-based product. So Mule is a Java-based product. So this particular product is developed by MuleSoft company, and by using the Java, they develop this particular product. Okay. And by using the Mule, we will be able to provide the enterprise service bus solutions, ESB solutions to our clients. And we will be using the AnyPoint Studio. AnyPoint Studio is one of the environment, like Eclipse environment. By using this AnyPoint Studio, we are going to build the Mule applications. We are going to build the Mule applications. We are going to build the APIs, and we are going to build all our ESB solutions, whatever is required. Then you may get doubt, what is mean by ESB? What is mean by ESB? What is Enterprise Service Bus? So we are discussing that by using the Mule product, we can provide ESB solutions to our clients. Then obviously we'll get a doubt, what is mean by ESB? ESB stands for Enterprise Service Bus. We have already discussed, right? Now, the ESB is fundamentally an architecture. So ESB is nothing but an architecture. It is having some rules, set of rules and principles for integrating numerous applications together. So if your client is using multiple applications, to run their business, when you want to integrate that multiple applications together like a bus, then we will be using the ESB. We'll be using the ESB architecture. Okay. So ESB is basically an architecture. Where it will be used is whenever the client is using multiple applications. If you want to integrate these applications, why integration is required? we need to transfer the data from one applications to another applications. We need to communicate between these applications, right? So in that scenario, we will be using this ESB architecture. We'll be using this ESB architecture. Okay. So the purpose of the ESB architecture is, the core concept of ESB architecture is that we will integrate different applications by putting a communication bus between them and then enable each application to talk to the bus. So we will provide one architecture. There we are going to integrate all our applications to talk each other and transform the information and talk each other between the applications. That's what we'll be talking about in the ESB. So Enterprise Service Bus is basically an architecture having some rules and principles where we are going to integrate multiple applications so that what happened, these applications can talk each other and they can share the information. The applications can share the information that comes as an ESB. There are different ESBs, not only this. Mule is one of the ESB. We have Dellbhoomi is one of the ESB. And we have TIBCO, Oracle SOA, and we have Tenant, IBM Bus. There are a number of ESB tools in the market. But Mule is one of the famous and open source tool, very less price. Okay. And recently Salesforce company has acquired this Mule software. That's one of the reason why most of the clients are preferring last 3-4 months. Most of the clients are looking out is in April 2018, it means around 8 months back, Salesforce company has acquired MuleSoft tool. So MuleSoft has developed in 2009 by the Mule and it's got very famous in 2013. And after that, Salesforce has acquired around 8 months back in 2018 April. Okay. So I hope you have some basic idea now. What is Mule? Mule is one of the product developed by MuleSoft company to provide the ESB solutions to the client. So what is meant by ESB? Enterprise Service Bus. It is one of the architecture. What is the purpose of this ESB architecture? If ESB architecture is there, then the client can have multiple applications and integrate each other and each application can talk with another applications and share the information between the applications. Okay. So why the clients were using multiple applications? If you look at the architecture of software right from 1960, in 1960, we were using the batch process earlier. We used to store the data in floppies, floppy disk, and we used to process the batch-wise floppies and retrieve the information and transfer the information. Then in 1970s, we got client-server architecture. We'll be storing the data in a single server and we'll be having multiple clients and we'll be interacting with the server and share the information. And then in 1980s, we got three-tier architecture. Three-tier in the sense, we'll be having the presentation tier here in the front end where we will be accessing the application from the application tier. We'll be accessing either from one device or multiple devices. In application tier, you will be having the applications, nothing but a pages or reports. And once you access the application, that application will be connected internally to the database and data retrieval and data insert. This is what three-tier architecture happens. It's introduced in 1980s. Then in 1990, we got OLTP, online transaction processing. And then in 2000s, we got entire architecture. We got multiple n number of tiers we can attach, like application server, web service, database, like this. And now this is what happening. Now in the market, most of the clients are using SOA, service oriented architecture. So why the SOA is introduced is your database layer is different and your presentation layer is different. We are not going to disturb our database and presentation layer. Only the service layer is going to be modified. We can have different service layers here. Okay. So in SOA, we can have the multiple applications integrations part. So there we are using this integration flow. So anyone is having doubts here? Is everyone is clear? So when clients are using multiple applications, then only this particular Mule software is required for the client. This tool is required for the client. If client says, I am not using multiple applications, I am just using single application, or maybe two applications are using, not more than three, then I don't think so this Mule software is useful for the client. If there are any clients, they are using multiple applications, when you want to integrate these multiple applications for the client, then we will be using the Mule software. Okay. So why we will be using the multiple? We'll take an example. So why the clients are required? Why they have to use multiple applications? What is the purpose? Is we cannot say that a single software will satisfy all our clients' requirement, because when client is doing some business in the real time, they'll be providing a lot of services to their customers and their employees and for their suppliers and for publicity and for security and for storage and for presentation. They'll be using multiple applications. Obviously, they are supposed to use. For example, let's say Flipkart. We know that it is one of the number one in India e-commerce company who will provide the online services to the customers, and they have a flipkart.com. It's one of the website which is developed by using PHP and MySQL server. Okay, so flipkart.com is a website which is developed by using some web applications. Maybe they might have implemented PHP, or they might have implemented by using React or Java. Okay, so they have one web application, and to maintain their financial transactions, day-to-day financial transactions like their debits and credits, accounting transactions, they use Oracle software, Oracle EBS software they use. And to maintain the data storage, they use Microsoft Azure Cloud. Because huge data, some millions of transactions every day, they are going to hit, they are going to get it into the applications. So that information storage purpose, they use Microsoft Azure. And also they are using for online transactions, they use SQL Server. For immediate actions, they use SQL Server. And also they use the Java for security reasons. When when the online payments are going on, so they would like to have a Java for security purpose. And also they use mobile devices to provide the mobile device access to the customers like this. So the Flipkart company is only one, the enterprise is only one, but they are using multiple applications, multiple softwares to maintain their business transactions, day-to-day transactions. So when the clients are using these multiple applications, whatever information they have entered in the web application, by end of the day or immediately, they would like to transfer to Oracle. So this application is web application. This application is Oracle application. So how you are going to give an integration between these two? We cannot directly integrate because it won't support directly. This may be in different format. This may be in the different format. So you need to provide a bus between the applications. There, the ESB comes into the picture. Enterprise Service Bus, where you are going to integrate all your clients' applications, where you are going to use all our clients' applications. That's what our Mule will do it. So the Mule product will be used to integrate between all these applications here. So it's clear, everyone? Anybody is having doubts here? Please let me know. Fine. So let me enter into the next step. Yes. So earlier, before this SOA integration or before this enterprise service bus, we were doing point-to-point integration. We were using the point-to-point integration. So let's say the customer is there. He want access. Customer in the sense user. He want access some data. He'll be using the database. Or your client might be using some mainframes. Your client might be using some other applications like SAP or Cloud or Azure like this. They might be using some applications. Okay. So when we say that point-to-point integration, in the initial stage, one or two applications, no problem. If there are two to three applications your client is using, point-to-point integration is not a problem. But when there are more than three, four applications, then point-to-point integration is not good enough. Okay. So whenever you have some small companies who are using only a couple of systems, used with small infrastructures, where only two or three systems must be integrated, this model can work quite well. So if your client says that I am just using only two applications, one is Oracle, another one is Java. So then point-to-point integration is fine. You can directly integrate with this. But if there are some big clients who are having number of applications, okay, so they have different version changes. So, okay, when, if there are any changes in the versions, nothing but latest versions, then point-to-point integration will become complex and it will be painful for the clients also. Obviously, it will be very painful because they have to purchase the latest versions and scalability also has to be verified and maintenance has to be verified. So it's going to be painful for the clients. So unless and until if there are only a couple of systems, then it is fine. Okay. There the ESB comes, Enterprise Service Bus. Okay. For example, you are an architect. So this is actually required. This particular slide is required for the project leader or project manager or for the pre-sales guys who are directly interacting with the client. So when you can suggest to your client, yes, please go for ESB, Enterprise Service Bus Architecture, and integrate your applications. Okay. So in which scenario is, make sure that you are integrating three or more applications or services. If you only need to communicate between two applications, please go for P2P integration. Point-to-point integration is better. ESB is not required. If client says that I have more than three applications or services I am using, I want to integrate these applications, yes, I can suggest, yes, you can go for ESB. You can go for Enterprise Service Bus Architecture. When client decide, okay, I'll go for ESB, Enterprise Service Bus, then which ESB I have to use? There are multiple ESBs available in the market. Mule is one of the ESB. Oracle is offering one of the ESB. TIBCO is offering. Dellbhoomi is one of the ESB. And IBM Bus is one of the ESB. Like that, multiple ESBs are available in the market. But Mule ESB is open source. Mule ESB is open source tool, very successful, and most of the clients has already implemented. With the approval of this, all ESB, Mule ESB from different clients, maximum feedback has given the positive regarding the Mule ESB. Now, Salesforce company has acquired this Mule ESB. You might be knowing Salesforce is one of the number one CRM cloud services in the world right now. Right now, it is one of the number one CRM Salesforce. Okay. So, Salesforce company has acquired this Mule ESB so that they can offer to the clients. Okay. So, that is the first checklist. So, as a pre-sales person or as a project manager or as an architect, if I am interacting with the client, when we can suggest ESB to the client is if the client is using three or more applications to communicate each other, then we'll suggest to go for ESB. And then we'll suggest to go for Mule ESB. Okay. Next, second one is, will you really need to plug in more applications in the future? So if the clients wanted to go for plug-in in the future, more applications, then only ESB is required. Otherwise, not it's required. So do you want to go for communicate through the protocols like HTTP, especially web services? Nowadays, we know that, right? For example, we'll go to Make My Trip. It's a very real-time example most of the people knows. Okay. So if we go to Make My Trip and we'll select the flight number and we will select the date from date to date and number of tickets required. And when we click the button, the information will be retrieved from the different web applications into your web. Okay. So that's where the integration is required. So across protocol messaging. If cross-protocol messaging and transferation is required, there your Mule will provide that. Okay, your Mule is going to provide. Mule ESB is going to provide. So when we are saying that message transformation between one application to another application, there will be more messages we need to transfer. There will be more messages we need to transfer. So that time also we will be using the Mule messages option. There is an option called Mule messages option. And the another checklist what we can do is, do you want to publish your services and any other applications that is good for Mule, because that option is there, Mule available. So when we are going for any big projects, when we are working with the big clients, when they have more than 10 applications to integrate. So if you want to avoid big bang projects, okay, breaking down projects and all, then we can also offer the ESB. And scalability if required, we can offer the ESB. Like this, the checklist will be used by the project manager. This is project managers. It's not for the Mule developers. I'm just showing you what are the checklists we will take care or we will check before we introduce ESB, Mule ESB to the clients. So if you are not able to understand some of the points, not a problem, leave this, because this is required for very high level positions. Okay. So as just now we discussed the checklist, if client is using only two devices, front end and detail service, means only two applications, this ESB is not required. So you can go for point to point integration. If you look at the case study 2, your client is using some front-end application, means web application, and your client is using some other applications, detailed service 1, service 2, service 3 like FTP, JMS services, REST, SOAP services. Some people may be very new to all these words, no problem, we'll be discussing right from the basics. What is FTP? What is REST API? What is SOAP API? What is JMS? What is routers? Okay. What are connectors we have? This all we'll be discussing. What is cloud? We'll be discussing right from the basics. The people who are already working in the industry, they can easily understand these words. If you are not clear this API's integrations, no problem, we'll be discussing. So in the second case, the client is using multiple applications. So obviously here we will offer the ESB, Enterprise Service Bus. Here it's not required. Here it's not required because there are only two applications, there are only two applications or services. Here, which integration is required? Point to point integration is required. Directly you can communicate. But here, no. Multiple services are there. More than three or more than services or applications are there. Better to have ESB architecture, enterprise service bus architecture, and each service or application will communicate with your bus and exchange the data. Exchange the data. From here, whatever data is coming, that will be exchanged and transformed. And it will be transformed. Is clear, everyone? Anybody is having the doubts here? Ramakrishna, your doubt is Java is required to complete this course. Basic Java is required, Ramakrishna. We will provide you that that details, not a problem. But you should be a basic have idea of the programming, like what is variable, what is control statement, what is for loop, what is exception. In any language, not only in Java, maybe you might be knowing some C language or PLSQL or some other languages, not a problem. Yes, Ramesh, if you are not from technical background, it takes some time for you to understand. Okay, so you are in IT, right? You are able to understand why Mule is required. Okay, so we are providing the this particular course for the people who are freshers also, who are not having any idea about the programming or technical also, we will provide. But you need to invest some more time. We will provide you some videos and assignments and additional classes in the weekends. Okay, so you have to attend those classes and gain the knowledge and continue with the people who are already having IT experience. Okay, you need to attend the special classes so that it will be good. Okay, so I hope everybody is clear what is ESB, Enterprise Service Bus. Yes, Avinash will be discussing RAML. Yes, we'll be talking about AnyPoint Studio, RAML, queues, API creations, API integrations. Yes. Rajkumar, OSB is also one of the ESB. It is like a service bus. This is for enterprises. This is for enterprise service bus. It is only for the people who are using the enterprise applications or enterprise services. Then ESB will be used. Is clear? So now you can see that enterprise service bus we will be having here. We are going to have the enterprise service bus here, and the architecture will shows that here only you are going to define your architecture in enterprise service bus, where the SAP can integrate and it can communicate with this. Okay, for example, you are using some web application here and you are passing some information in the XML format. Your information is coming in the XML format and your SAP is accepting XML format. That's fine, not a problem. But mainframe is expecting JSON format, and some other application is expecting in .NET format. So what ESB has to do is, this enterprise service bus has to exchange the message into different formats. From whatever the format you are received, it has to exchange into XML format or JSON or CSV. In any format, it has to change these options. It has to change these options here. So once we configure the enterprise service bus today, for example, after some time, the client has started using one more application. The client has started using one more application. Let's say they started using mobile application. You can easily integrate with this service bus. no need to disturb the existing architecture. We don't need to disturb the existing architecture. It won't be any problem for, there won't be any problem for existing applications here. At the same time, even if the client is going for cloud environment, so we'll be discussing also cloud, what are different clouds we have. So these all are basic level. Like generally, people who are already working in the IT, everybody can easily understand what is ERP, what is cloud SaaS model, what is web service, okay, what is on-premises. These all words everybody can understand. For the people who are freshers, like if you are not having any idea of this all, don't worry about it, because the training we will be providing with right from the basics. But you need to attend the special classes when we are talking about all these basics. Okay. So if the client is going for any cloud environment after some time, that also can be easily integrated with our service bus without disturbing the existing infrastructure. That is the major advantage of Enterprise Service Bus, ESB. Obviously, Mule ESB will support all these options. Whatever options are required, that it will support. So, Enterprise Service Bus is a software architecture for middleware, and it supports SOA architecture, service-oriented. We discussed in the starting of the session that most of the clients nowadays, they are using SOA, service-oriented architecture. And you can see that latest, we can see microservices recently, advanced to SOA, microservices. That will be the future. From 2020 onwards, the microservices is going to be the future. And our Mule ESB will support for microservices also. Not only for SOA, whatever we are talking about microservices architecture, it's going to be coming in the future, and already few big clients have started using microservices architecture. Our Mule ESB will support for SOA as well as for microservices. Okay, it will hide the complexity, as we discussed, if the client might be using different applications, Java and Oracle and other things. For example, we will go to ATM center. I hope everybody might have used ATM. You have ICICI Bank debit card, and you will go to HDFC ATM center, and you will draw some amount. So HDFC ATM center is running by using the mainframe software, for example. So whatever the amount you have drawn, that information should be transferred to ICICI Bank, right? That information should be transferred to ICICI Bank. ICICI might be using Oracle. They might be using some Java software. But HDFC Bank is using mainframes. So how these two will be integrated? That is a very complex integration, right? So there the ESB comes into the picture. There the ESB comes into the picture. Enterprise Service Bus. Enterprise Service Bus, where the Enterprise Service Bus is. So that is one of the best example. We cannot say that both HDFC and ICICI Bank are using the same software, right? HDFC might be using some mainframes and SAP and .NET. ICICI might be using some other applications. Obviously, when you draw the amount from the HDFC Bank ATM center, that information must be sent to the ICICI Bank, right? ICICI Bank servers. So there you need to transfer the message, nothing but information. Okay. So when you transfer an information, there the integration comes. Complex integrations. So our Mule ESB will support for complex integrations, here it is. Yes, OSB also support microservices, Rajkumar. Yes. Simplify the access, how we can access the applications, we can easily. Obviously, every database canonical pattern, it will be designed. So our ESB should support this. And integration driven by the business requirement. not by the available technology. So whenever we are interacting with the client, we will gather the client business requirement. According to the requirements, we have to integrate the application. It's not like we have this technology, let's use this technology. Okay. So we have to go for implementing this integration according to the business requirements, not like available technology. It's not like, okay, we have a technology, let's integrate. So it depends on the business requirement. We are going to provide the solution. We are going to provide the integration solution by using the ESP. So these all are ESP futures. These all are ESP futures, enterprise service bus. So we will see almost routing of the messages and message transformation. As we have already discussed, let's say you received a message in XML format, but another application is accepting only JSON format. Then what we have to do? This XML format should be transformed into JSON format or CSV format or Word format or any other formats by using different technologies like application APIs. That's all we will be doing in the Mule ESB message enhancement. For example, you received the message called A, but another application is expecting something called A plus 10. So you have to enhance your message, means you have to add some more information. You have to add some more information to your message. That's called message enhancement. Okay. So that we have to transfer. So message enhancement, it will support protocol transformation. When we are using HTTP transfers, like FTP is there, SFTP is there, secured file transfer protocol, and we will be using REST and SOAP APIs, JMSQs. This all it has to support protocol transformation, service mapping, web services mapping. Okay, and then we will be having message processing. Messages is nothing but information. It's not any, it's not something new. It's information when you are exchanging between the applications. We call it as a message processing. Process choreography means sending the messages one by one. Service oriented orchestration, and it has to go for transaction management. When we are performing some transactions in the applications, it should support for all the management of transactions. And the final, security. So obviously security is required for any information exchange between the applications, because nowadays we know that most of the applications are online applications which are exchanged. So these all are features of the ESB. It's not something, it looks like theoretical part, but it's not something new. It's in ESB futures. So Mule ESB will provide all this. So this is the, at any point studio is used. By using any point studio only, we are going to develop Mule applications and we are going to develop APIs. Okay, once we develop this APIs, we will be deploying in the different applications. We can also deploy in the cloud environment all these Mule runtime applications by using AnyPoint Studio. AnyPoint Studio is like an environment. It is an environment where we are going to build our Mule applications. It's as simple as we have MS Word software. By using MS Word software, I'll prepare my resume. By using MS Word software, I'll prepare my course syllabus. By using my MS Word software, I'll prepare my invoice. These all are documents, right? So the base is MS Word is a software. In the same way, AnyPoint Studio is one of the environment, is one of the environment where we are going to build our Mule applications. Once you build your Mule applications or Mule APIs, that you are going to deploy in the cloud or in the on-premises, in any of the place you are going to run your Mule applications. Okay, so AnyPoint Studio is one of the environment. So where we are going to build our integrations graphically, whatever the integration you are doing in the MuleSoft, that is graphical visualization, that internally it is going to prepare, internally it is going to prepare the XML format. Internally it's going to prepare the XML format, of course, so that XML format also we can understand. Most of the people may not be knowing the idea of XML tags. Of course, we will provide you the training on the XML tags also, whatever is required. So you can go for built-in templates are available, built-in connectors are available, built-in examples are there. You can go through that and you can start integrating your applications. If you go to AnyPoint Studio, we have built-in connectors, built-in templates and examples. By using this, you can start your integrations. And you can debug your Mule application or API at the time of designing time. You can go for handle the errors or Java and XML. All the things can be handled. You can map and transform the data easily, and integration of the testing. You can easily do it by using Mule Unit, and you can easily develop your own Mule APIs, and you can also deploy the APIs and integrations. You can deploy your Mule APIs either in the cloud or in the on-premises. So at AnyPoint Studio is one of the environment where we are going to build all our Mule applications. Yes, Basha. Basha, you are on video only, Basha. I cannot unmute. I am not getting that option. Yes, Avinash, please go ahead.
Hi, so can you please explain this integrate testing your existing CI/CD process using MUnit further, and also more about the deployment ways, how we deploy, because there is something called Jenkins and Bitbucket and GitHub, using those also there we deploy Mule applications. So
yes, see, whatever the tools you referred, Jenkins, these all tools generally we use in the DevOps. Okay, so it will be used in the DevOps when we are going to integrate the applications, and whatever the Mule APIs or applications we built, that we are going to use by using this Jenkins. All in any environment you can easily deploy it and execute. Okay, so that we'll be discussing. We will be discussing how we can integrate our Mule applications with Docker image, and also how it will be working with Jenkins, as well as we have separate Mule unit, as well as we have the MQs. That all we'll be discussing. Okay. Well, as this is a demo, I'm not going for that level. When I'm explaining the syllabus of our course, you will be able to understand what we are going to cover. Okay. Is okay, Avinash? Are you clear? Fine, guys. This is our AnyPoint Studio. Here only we are going to build our Mule applications, and we are going to design our Mule APIs. And here you can see the left side, we have the project package explorer. Here only we are going to build our Mule applications. Here we can see our project structure, nothing but source files and other Mule applications deployment, this all here we have. And then this is what we call it as a canvas. We are going to drag and drop our blocks, building blocks, whatever the Mule flow you would like to create, here it will be doing. So this is a visualization flow, like look and feel, the complete visualization. Whatever the Mule flow we have designed, we can see that. Internal configuration XML we can find here. Configuration XML, we'll see here, configuration XML option. Means the moment when you design the Mule flow, it looks like from the front end graphical, but internally XML code will be generated. That we have to go to this tab, configuration XML tab, to see what XML code is generated. And the moment whenever you select your mule blocks, these all are the different blocks we have, like scopes, connectors, exceptions, these all options we have. The moment when you drag and drop your mule block, immediately it will show you the properties. I'll show this practically now. I'm just showing you. So mule properties will find. Once the mule application is designed and when you start running the mule application, then we can see the console window. There we can see the running process and we can go for deployment. Yes. Okay. So seems Basha is on. Yes, Basha, please go ahead. Fine, Basha, it seems there is some problem from your end. Let me continue. You can, I think you entered some doubt here. Yes, Basha, you are working as a SOA developer. Is Mule SB? Yes, 100%, Basha, as you are already in the SOA environment. Always Mule ESB is going to be helpful to improve your career. It is always, you will get an option. It's 100% suitable. So what are the building blocks we have in, what are the building blocks we have in the MuleSoft, in the Mule application, what are the building blocks we have here? First one is a connectors. So connectors are used mainly to set the endpoint, And if you want to send and receive the messages and host and addresses and port numbers, will be using the connectors. Then we have the components. So mainly when you want to write some JavaScript or any JSON script or any web services, then we'll be using the components. Over here it is. And we will have the transformers. So the transformers are mainly when you want to go for transform the messages, you will have the message separate format with header and inbound property, outbound property. And also you will be having here it is the messages and with payload options, then we'll be using transformers. And filters, whenever you wanted to go for add some values like calculations, add or not, or custom, if you want to create your own filter, then it will be used. If you want to go for add your own filter also, you can add. And if there are bulk messages when you are going to transfer, message flow, when you are preparing the message flow, sometimes we need to split the message flow and we need to change the order of the flow. In that scenario, we'll be using the routers. Routers will be used. And we will have the different scopes of processing the blocks. You can have the logger. And obviously when you start using any of this block, you are supposed to handle the runtime errors, exception strategies. You are supposed to define this. When you want to handle this, then it will be used. These are the main building blocks at any point studio. Let me open that. So whatever I have explained you, that you can see that this is any point studio software. So this software we can download directly from any point studio or MuleSoft website. We can download and go for installation. I'll show you how to do it. Installation in the first session itself. Okay, so I'm going to show you very simple mule flow. I'm going to design one simple mule flow now. Okay, so let me go for have a simple project. If you want to close the existing project, it can be closed. Select new mule project. Avinash, we are using 3.9 version. 3.9. Now the 4 version also released into the market right now, but they have not provided for practice. It's purely for commercial. Still they have not it. But we'll be discussing about different versions, old versions which are compatibility and what are new options are released in the latest version. This all we'll be discussing theoretically. When we are applying for a job, generally they will expect right from 3.9 because it's introduced around 2 years back. Okay. So we must be clear about this 3.9 and the latest version is a 4. And 6.5 is the version which we are using AnyPoint Studio. Now latest version is 7 or Mule has introduced 7 version. Okay. So I'm just going for a simple Mule project. Just give the project name and click finish. So the purpose of this project is very simple. Let's say I have a folder called source and I would like to transfer to another folder called destination. There are some files in my source folder. So what your Mule should do it is it should pick up all the files which are available in the source folder and it has to transfer all these files into destination folder within the same application. Here it is. Within the same application, here it has to transfer. Okay. This is what we are going to do now. It's very simple and easy to understand. When we start building the simple Mule applications, then later we'll be doing complex. Later we'll be doing the complex applications. Okay, fine. So first I'll create 2 folders, source and destination. 2 folders I'm going to create. Let me go to D drive or you can go for any E drive also. I'm creating 2 folders here. One is source. Let me keep some files inside of this folder. There are some files in the source folder. And I'm going for another folder called destination. So 2 folders are ready in my system. Yeah. Give me 1 minute, please. Meanwhile, please enter your phone number and email ID so that we will share this demo video session and the next batch details all we are going to send it to the everyone. Please drop your phone number and email. Fine. I'm sorry, guys. I just got it. Here it is. Fine. So now, let me disable this all options. So what we wanted to do is we would like to transfer the files from source folder into destination folder. So what is our activity? This only we discussed just now. We talked about connectors, we talked about scopes, we talked about components, we talked about transformers, we talked about filters, flow control, and then we talked about this options here, error handling. So right now in the presentation, just now I shown, right, all building blocks, connectors, components, transforms, scopes, filters, errors, these are all these are here. We can search also. Right now I would like to perform some activity related to the file. So just go for drag here, this file, select. So select the file here. And here we will be mentioning the path from which folder you would like to transfer the files. Source, that's a folder. For which folder you would like to transfer. Select, again it's a file operation, destination. This is destination folder. So now it's showing me there are no errors. Both, we don't have any errors. Meanwhile, if you want to write some log information, you can use another one, logger. Go to logger, and whatever message you would like to write into the log file, you can write. So RTL MuleSoft training file transfers. So I have used only three blocks here. One is file, another one is a logger. Two activities I have used. This is what our message flow I have designed. You can see that it is an internal XML file is generated. Where we can see this XML file, go to this tab, configuration XML. It is showing me that the XML version. This is basic information about MuleSoft that we will find default in every Mule application. We'll see that. And we can see the flow name here, name of the flow. Whatever name you have provided, first flow. And then you have used file, logger, and then you have used the file. That's what. First I have used the file, then logger, and then file. So here it is visualization. So here it is showing visually the same design we can see in XML format here. And here in the file, you can see that you provided this path. Properties, okay, and this is a logger, and there you have provided the message, this message, and the level, what is level we'll discuss later. And in the file here we can see this is your inbound endpoint, this is your outbound, and we have specified. Generally it's not required unless and until we want to make some changes in XML codes. This XML codes, for the people who are not familiar, it's very difficult in the initial stage. But if we try to understand for some time, maybe a couple of hours time it will take to understand. But once we understand, it's very easy. Only it will be a complete code part. But once we understand, it will be easy. Okay. So now we have designed one simple Mule message flow. This we wanted to run as a Mule application. Okay, so let's make sure that you have a destination folder which is empty, and you have a source folder which is having around 7 files are available in this folder. So let me run this, run as Mule application. So now you can see the console window. It's as I told, this is a Java product. Internally, Java console is running. Before you install the Mule software, make sure that Java is installed in your system, either Java 7 or Java 8 JDK. Java Developer Kit must be installed, either 7 or 8, not a problem. And you can see that the message has been done. So first it has started. Don't worry, it looks like lengthy information. It's very simple. So it has picked up the files, whatever 7 files are there, it has picked. And this is a information. It is showing me that 7 times it has been transferred the files here. Now you can check this in the destination folder. Where is the destination folder? Here it is. And earlier it was in source folder. All the files has been moved from source folder into the destination folder. Okay, this is within the application. You don't find much complexity within the application when we are transferring the messages or files or transactions. But when we are working with multiple applications, definitely we will find the challenge and complexity here. Yes. Okay. So like this, we'll be working with the Mule applications. And here is our syllabus. This is going to be MuleSoft developer, and you will be applying for a job after completion of this course as a MuleSoft developer. So once you are clear my course theoretically and practically, maximum you can put 2 to 3 years. Generally 2 years the company is expecting, because the product has got success, more success in 2016. Okay, fine. So here we can find a lot of jobs. Here it is. And that we will be discussing. And this is going to be our knowledge on basic Java is preferred or any other. And we'll be explaining you the, as I told, so people who are freshers, they'll not be having idea what is XML format. CSV might be knowing everybody, but still we'll be discussing what is CSV, what is JSON, no? What is HTTP, JMS, JDBC, REST API, SOAP. This all we'll be discussing. And which role you can apply once the completion of this course, which role, developers roles you can apply. And if you are already working in SOA architecture, you have already some idea about other ESB tools, then obviously you can go for apply as a program manager or integration specialist. These all roles can be applied, and it takes 25 to 30 days program. And we are conducting this course from Bangalore. And if you are interested in the classroom training, you can come to our Bangalore office. Please contact Mr. Naresh from RTL Technologies. He is the person who is conducting this training coordinator. It takes 30 working hours, as I told. And some of the topics we may not be able to explain you. Obviously, we have to discuss, but we may not be able to show you practically explanation, not possible. That obviously we have to discuss, at least theoretically, we'll be talking. And these are the course outline. We'll be talking about AnyPoint platform introduction, how to build the applications, Mule applications. We'll be learning Mule expression language, how to build applications, run testing and debugging Mule applications. Okay. And how we can work with the web services, REST and SOAP, RML. This all we'll be discussing. And how we can interact with additional resources like files, database, any cloud SaaS applications like Salesforce, how to interact with this. Transform the data. We will be writing some data wave coding. We'll be talking about data wave coding that we'll be discussing. and we'll be discussing how to run the multiple applications, mule flows, how we can create across the multiple applications. Obviously, handling the errors we have to discuss in every example, and how you can control your message flows, means based on some condition, changing the message flows and applications, how we can process the records and building the REST RML and API is very important for Mule APIs. Standard APIs we'll be using, how to write our own APIs and deploying the applications, Mule applications, and data wave we will be discussing. 3.7 is there and 3.9. Oh, obviously, both are similar almost. Okay, so these versions we'll be talking about here. So this is the syllabus. Please talk with Mr. Naresh. He is the coordinator regarding the batch timings and course and other. Yes, Avinash, I'll be providing you the certification details. We'll support for certification details. We can perform the certification also. So please drop your thank you. Thank you everyone for your valuable time spending with me to know about Mule ESB software integration tool. So it's very good in the market right now. So it's a very good in the future. Now we know that every client is using multiple applications. Obviously they are supposed to use multiple applications here. So when they are using multiple applications, obviously they are supposed to use the integration tools. Mule is one of the open source and more flexible tool this is used here, and it's going to be applied. Thank you. Please drop your phone number and email ID to know the next batch details, class details and everything. It will be started. Thank you. Thank you everyone.